So we'll start with one of the highlights of this conference, which is the award of the 2010 Dirac Medal. So let me just say some words about the Dirac Medal. The medal is given in honor of P.A.M. Dirac, one of the greatest physicists of the 20th century, and a staunch friend of the center. It is awarded annually on Dirac's birthday, 8th of August, to scientists who have made significant contributions to theoretical physics. The center awarded its first Dirac Medal in 1985, so we are celebrating the 25th anniversary of that. An international committee of distinguished scientists selects the winners from the list of nominated candidates. The committee invites nominations from scientists working in all areas of theoretical physics. Nobel laureates, Fields medalists, and Wolf Prize winners are not eligible for the award, though many Dirac medalists have gone on to win those prizes. We have some present here. There is a cash award in addition to the medal. This year, for the 2010 Dirac Medal Selection Committee, the committee was composed of Professors Michael Green, Alan Guth, Giorgio Parisi, Helen Quinn, and Steven Weinberg. So let me start with a few words about Dirac. Paul Adrian Maurice Dirac was born in Bristol, England, on 8th of August 1902. He studied engineering in his hometown and obtained his degree in physics and mathematics at Cambridge University, where in 1932 he became professor of mathematics and in the location chair, which had been held by Sir Isaac Newton 2 centuries earlier, and you know later on by Stephen Hawking, and now Michael Green, who is present here. After his retirement, Professor Dirac went to live in Tallahassee, Florida, where he taught at Florida State University from 1971 until his death on 20th of October 1984. A member of the Royal Society since 1930, he won the Royal Medal in 1939 and the Copley Medal in 1952. Professor Dirac shared the Nobel Prize for Physics with Erwin Schrödinger in 1933. He invented the well-known relativistic wave equation, predicting the existence of spin and of the positron when he was only 23 years old. His further work includes his formulation of quantum field theory, statistics of fields and particles, gravitational waves, and the prediction of magnetic monopoles. Dirac first came to Trieste in June 1968 on the occasion of the International Symposium on Contemporary Physics, at which he delivered a lecture on the methods of theoretical physics. After this symposium, Dirac was a guest honor at the center for a month or so nearly every year. In 1972, at the Symposium on the Physicist's Conception of Nature organized in honor of Dirac, on the occasion of his 70th birthday, he gave a lecture on fundamental constants and their development in time. Dirac also attended the Marcel Grossman meeting held at the center on the centennial of the birth of Albert Einstein in 1979. Abdus Salam, who proposed the institution of the Dirac Medal, was Dirac's student at Cambridge, and it was after having listened to Dirac's lecture that he decided to devote his life to research rather than becoming a civil servant in his country. He remained in touch with his master and became his friend. So by preparing for this occasion, we have been reading some material of Dirac, and I invite you all to look at an exhibition we have about some of the letters and documents that we have from Dirac's exchanges with Abdus Salam. And I would like to share with you a couple of anecdotes that we read, which is, you know, that Dirac is one of the most interesting characters in the history of physics, and we all have stories of Dirac. And these two, myself, I didn't know them, so I would like to share them with you. In a meeting where this is a comment from Werner Heisenberg, the famous Heisenberg of the uncertainty principle. He has this speech about Salam. He said, when I am asked to give a speech at such a sudden moment, I cannot do anything but just tell stories. I should perhaps tell a story about our common trip on the United States and to Japan. That reminds me, I should perhaps relate the two incidents in this story. One was that we had agreed to meet at the hotel, the Old Faithful Geyser in Yellowstone, and I had written to Paul that it would be nice if we could look at some of the geysers going off just at the moment that they go off. When we met, I found that he had made out a very careful timetable of all the geysers, which one could possibly reach at the time of the going off. And he also wrote out the distance from one geyser to the next. Thus, we could walk over in such a way that by a careful, very careful selected trip, we could actually see quite a number of them going up. Mm-hmm. So then you know that Paul always thinks about his formulations very carefully. So he doesn't like to answer spontaneously at once. And he first thinks about things. We were on the steamer from America to Japan, and I like to take part in the social life on the steamer. And so, for instance, I took part in the dances in the evening. Paul somehow didn't like that too much, but he would sit in a chair and look at the dances. Once I came back from a dance and took the chair beside him, and he asked me, "Heisenberg, why do you dance?" I said, "Well, when there are nice girls, it is a pleasure to dance." So he thought for quite a long time about it, and after 5 minutes, he said, "Heisenberg, how do you know beforehand that the girls are nice?" So this is one of the many examples of Dirac's behavior. So today we are here to celebrate the two winners of the 2010 Dirac Medal. So I will state what the mention says: that 2010 Dirac Medal and Prize are awarded to Nicola Cabibbo of the University of La Sapienza, Rome, Italy, and Ennackal Chandy George Sudarshan, University of Texas in Austin, USA, in recognition of their fundamental contributions to the understanding of weak interactions and other aspects of theoretical physics. So let's applaud both of them.